2018 Honda Civic Type R. This is a GT. This is on the road at roughly around £33,500, but you can get a Type R standard for around about £31,500 on the road. But when you go for the GT spec, you get a little bit of a extra interior and, technology features, mainly being that you're going to have blind spot assist, auto dimming rear view mirrors, parking sensors and stuff, 320 PS, 400 Newton meters of torque, 0 to 62 miles an hour in 5.8 seconds, and tops out at the best part 170 miles an hour. Scary. Now, while I accept that 5.8 to 62 isn't the fastest, because a Golf R does it in a second quicker, does it in 4.8-ish, unless you have a wagon, then it's more like 5.2. This is a... It's a car that once it's got traction, it will walk all over the competition, because realistically, that's the only thing that stops it. It struggles off the mark. 400 Newton meters to put down on the floor is a lot of power to get down. Gigging test part one. So that is the load capacity part of it. Now, I know the standard Civic, the normal hatchback is very, very good at taking a lot of equipment, as I saw in my review a while ago. What I want to know is that this being the Type R, has that amazing boot space been compromised, and am I going to struggle to get everything in because I didn't before? There's the answer. The luggage space has not been compromised, and this is just as capable as it was as a standard Civic, except now it's a bit more muscly. From the outside, the new Civic is entirely redesigned. So a standard on any variant, you do get these 20-inch, now I've got to remember this, Baleno alloy wheels. They look amazing. Combine that with the fact that you've got Brembo discs and calipers on the front, the outside's starting to look really good. Did I forget to mention it's got a huge wing on the back of it as well? And this particular one is finished in Rally Red, so it really is a bright, shouty color. This is a bright, shouty car. But outside, it looks great, and especially as a saloony hatch, Honda have done a great job in making this a beautiful, beautiful car to look at. Second part of the gig test is the, well, drive to the gig. How well does it do? Is it comfortable? Is it frugal? How does it cope? And being a gig test, all my equipment's in the back. So really, this is just a daily commuting test, but with more weight in the back, and that's about it. Let's go. Fair few miles down, and 38 miles per gallon average is what I got. Now, what I've discovered is that if you drive this in sport, it's a bit stiffer for daily. Put it in comfort, it's more than usable on a daily basis. The fuel economy, 38. I have a feeling if I actually drove faster than the 65 I was at and just maybe kept it 70, it probably could have got better, but then I would have got stuck up behind people and it would have brought it down. But on a clear run, I think it can do better than that. I think this is actually a very frugal engine, considering it's 320 PS, 315 brake horsepower-ish. It's really, really good, and it's superb for commuting, because if you get bored and you're on the motorway, even in sixth gear, you put your foot down, go straight for an overtake without question. It can do it.
Move inside and you get a typically refined and really, really lovely place to be. It's typically Honda. The only thing that isn't typically Honda is the infotainment, because it's really out of date and quite difficult to use. It was the same in the 1 litre VTEC EcoBox Civic that I drove last year, and it hasn't been updated since, and that's the only thing that holds it back, because these seats, the bolsters are strong and they hold you in place. The seat belts don't cut into your neck, and everything's where you want it to be. The funny thing is though, even though you've got ISOFIX in the back, you don't have three seats like you would do in the normal Civic, you've only got two. Visibility from the driving seat is really, really good. Really big wing mirrors. And even though you've got that big wing on the back, it doesn't really deter from what you can see. However, reversing out you do need that technology, that assistant that you get in the GT pack to let you know if you're reversing out in front of someone, because there is a massive blind spot thanks to the wing and the big rear panel, basically. Continuing on with the interior, we covered the front, the driver's area. It's great, everything's where you need it to be. Everything's comfortable. The back seat, well, ample leg room, only two belts, but still ISOFIX. So if you're looking at it as a daily family car, well, that's entirely doable. You get to the boot, and this is where a lot of hot hatches, that's where you find out there's an issue, because being a hot hatch, there's less room in there. But Honda have made it so it's just as usable as a standard. As the standard Civic that I drove, it takes just as much stuff, it's just as versatile, but it's just got a lot more power. And to a performance point of view, that's the big thing about this car. 320 PS, what's that, 315 brake horsepower, 400 newton meters of torque. It will propel you to 62 miles an hour in, well, roughly 5.8, 5.9 seconds. I've seen quicker. If this can put the traction down, it really, really boots. So you can't even compare this to a Golf R, because once you're moving, the Golf R doesn't really stand a chance. And especially when you get on the back roads, because finally, Civic's got fully independent rear suspension.
A back to basics fuel economy challenge, and excuse us here, I just can't be bothered to fix it. So this is a back road fun car, but what fuel economy can you get on back road? So I'm not going to be going flat out, I'm not going to be driving hard, but I'm going to be driving spiritedly to see what this can return on a back road sort of blast. I'm expecting high 20s to low 30s, nothing above that. This can get good fuel economy, but back roads, well, you just might as well accept that you're not going to. The result was a 30.3 miles per gallon, and while there were a few blips of giving it full beans, within reason on public roads, especially in the UK with how congested it is, you're not going to find yourself flat out constantly. So it's done pretty well, considering. You could get considerably better if you didn't have fun, but he buys a Type R and doesn't drive it and have fun.
The previous versions handled really, really well, but they felt a little bit loose at the back. Finally, the Civic feels completely planted, and with the different drive mode selectors that you can get, it's entirely customizable. During the week, you can drive it as a economy hatch, sort of, and get about 34, 35 miles per gallon, but you can have it in comfort mode. The suspension won't break your back. But the weekend, you want to be doing some hard driving, you put it in R mode, and by God, you're leaving most things behind. And that's really what this is. It feels fantastic. The driving position is amazing, the weighted steering is fantastic, the brakes feel amazing, and the distribution, you don't ever feel like you're going to understeer into anything, because this car just holds and hugs and holds and hugs, and no matter what you throw at it, it won't let go. And that's really why the economy doesn't really matter, but it can get sort of what it says on paper. You will see like 42, 43 if you're really careful, more likely to see about 38 and around town anywhere between 20 to 25. It depends how heavy your right foot is, really. But it's a entirely usable hot hatch, because if you don't want to drive it hard, it doesn't mind being driven soft. But if you want to put your foot down, by God, it goes, and it sounds great. In fact, with the three exhausts on the back, it looks great. It really stands out, but it could be a little bit louder.
I suppose when you have a Type R, you'll probably spend a lot of time driving to car events and a fair bit of time on motorways. So it's good to know what it can turn around. So let's hit to a dual carriageway. Let's sit at 65, literally 65, maybe 70. Let's see what the road conditions are. It's completely flat, and let's get a best case scenario. Relatively flat run, it's turned around 40.6 miles per gallon, which is really good considering what Honda put on paper this can get. They say it can get like, I think it's like 44 to 46 miles per gallon. It's not that far off, and realistically you probably could hit that target if you were very careful and very lucky, but
general day-to-day basis, this really is quite a frugal hot hatch considering the power and drive you get. And as a final summary, for £33,500 on the road, or £31,500 if you're going for a Boggo spec one, you get everything you need. The GT does come with a slightly louder sound system, and it does come with some extra electronic aids and amenities, nothing to change your driving, but it does come with a few extra bits that are quite nice. But otherwise, it's still a great driving car, even at 31.5. And actually, I'd say, value for money-wise, it is the best value for money that I think that you can get in a hot hatch, above all the competition. And while it may not be the biggest boot, and while it may not have all the traction, it may not be the fastest, I find this the best driving. So Honda, if you're watching this, 11 out of 10 for the driving factor, 8 out of 10 for the fuel efficiency, 11 out of 10 for money as well. I don't know why I'm saying 11 out of 10. I just might as well say 10 out of 10. I'm just trying to make a point. It's really good value for money. And if you drive one of these and you own one of these and you enjoy it, I'm jealous of you, because I have to give this back tomorrow.